Today, one call for help is unusual and potentially very serious.
Hello, free request for you in Pickering, anaphylaxis.
Dispatcher Al is scrambling HeliMed 99.
HeliMed 99 Alpha is lifting and departing outbound to the east of the Vietnam Black Hole.
Anaphylaxis is an extreme immune reaction to an allergy. It kills 20 people every year in the UK.
Got reports of a 14-year-old who had an anaphylactic reaction to something. It sounds like this person's probably had a reaction before to whatever's caused it. The crew will be concerned that they deteriorate en route to hospital. Give us a call.
Pilot Chris is heading for a secondary school, serving a rural area on the edge of the North York Moors.
We've got the school.
About the rest of it. Got the ambulance. I'll go for the big playing field.
That's good to me.
Paramedic Tony knows there's no time to waste.
So we've got Libby, 14-year-old,
yep.
Who's got idiopathic anaphylaxis.
Right.
Multiple triggers.
Right.
An episode 2 weeks ago.
Right.
Very similar to now. En route, she deteriorated rapidly. Ended up in recess for 4 or 5 hours.
Okay.
She's starting with a rash around the base of her neck.
Okay.
Her lips are swollen, her tongue appears to be swelling.
Right.
Her face is beginning to swell.
Right.
4,000 people are taken to hospital every year with anaphylaxis, but few cases are as serious as the team's patient.
She's had two EpiPens. She just had 500 mics of adrenaline from us.
Hey, guys. Hey, mate. All right.
Libby is in the care of local paramedics. Her life has been saved by an EpiPen, but it's feared she may suffer a relapse at any moment.
She has a headache of 10 out of 10 at the moment. Not really spoken to us, tongue's slightly swollen.
Is it evidence of a little bit of a rash?
And yeah, rash on the upper chest.
Okay.
And she now goes to York.
Mm-hmm.
Are you?
She's under a few other hospitals as well, Leeds, Newcastle, Sheffield,
well,
and London.
Yeah.
So that's the plan, is it? We're going to fly to Scarborough?
It's going to be quicker for us to fly to Scarborough.
Yeah.
For them to drive to York.
Yeah, fair enough.
Okay.
And Scarborough, happy to take.
I'm just going to ring him.
Right.
Speed is vital. They're going to fly her to doctors in Scarborough who are familiar with her case. She's suffered attacks like this on more than 100 occasions.
Yeah.
This young lady's got quite a complex medical history. She gets anaphylactic with serious allergic reactions for basically anything at all. No known trigger. It's known to deteriorate quite quickly. So the crew's arrived, they've stabilised it, but obviously given the circumstances, we're going to fly to the nearest resource department and get her fully checked and stabilised there before she goes anywhere else.
Right then, Libby, light thoughts.
Okay. Ready, steady, lift.
It's late afternoon at Air Ambulance HQ.
HeliMed 98, receiving.
Here, right, Lee.
Yeah, can you start prepping and head towards Pickering for detail, over?
Paramedics Lisa and Al are on the case.
Help out to Pickering.
Pilot Harry will have them there in just 8 minutes.
HeliMed 98, lift and depart.
Edisco 98, lifted, reaching Pickering.
HeliMed 98, assault B.
And the patient sounds familiar.
You're going to a 30-year-old female who's having an allergic reaction.
For the second dose of IM adrenaline, over.
Their destination is the school where a teenage pupil suffers from extreme allergic reactions.
OK, visual with the area of the school on the nose.
Yeah.
Are you happy with that?
Yeah.
A good mindset.
Cool, thank you. That person's staying out of the way. Yeah. Alright, I'm just going to go forward a bit just in case you have to load the patient. Right.
Okay.
Once again, the team have been called to 14-year-old Libby. Half an hour ago, she used her EpiPen after her tongue began to swell.
So when was the last time she had an episode?
She's had them every couple of weeks for the last 8 weeks.
Okay. And she always has a second attack, does she? Yeah.
It's happened many times before, but it's always terrifying for her and her mum.
What a pain, eh? And you don't know what triggers it.
There's a lot of stuff we do know, like medicines and certain things in the air.
Have you been unwell recently? Have you been on any meds?
No.
Keep asking your mum, I should ask you, shouldn't I? How are you feeling? All right.
Libby's condition means this flight will be high risk.
You guys, Al, will you just direct the crew while I give them a ring?
So Libby's quite complex. She's got anaphylactics, said over 100. She's got angioedema, heart condition. She's under investigation with quite a few different teams now to try and get to the bottom of it. We know certain medications. We know certain things that are airborne. A lot of it we don't know. They just happen for no reason. She can't go anywhere by herself. She has to always be with somebody, even in school and out of school. So, yeah, she's not an average 14-year-old girl.
At RAF Topcliff, Helimed 98 is once again preparing to take off for the market town of Pickering. For the third time in a few weeks, 14-year-old schoolgirl Libby's extreme allergies are threatening her life. Paramedics Sam and Lisa know each time an attack occurs, the more complex and unstable her condition becomes.
Some allergic reactions are really quite resistant to the normal drugs that we give, and the only thing that you can do with those people is take them to hospital quickly.
Hello. Hello, Libby. My name's Sam. I'm one of the paramedics. How many EpiPens have you had? Two, did you say?
Once again, her mum's been called to the school.
Do you feel like you've got any symptoms now? Any itching or shortness of breath?
My chest is itching.
Your chest is itching, is it? But you don't feel short of breath or anything like that? No? Very good. And what did you feel sort of was happening this afternoon, Libby? What sort of made you think you had a reaction coming on? Say again.
I started to feel sick.
Started to feel sick. With your history, we'll probably need to bob you down to the hospital.
They're flying Libby to York Hospital, where specialists have been handling her case. Her situation is very rare. She's been prescribed 7 different drugs, but none has provided a cure.
We're getting to know Libby quite well. A few of us have been to her now. Unfortunate circumstances, really, but hopefully they'll get to the bottom of it without much delay.
And the team know this may not be the last time they're called to Libby.